Rod, the plea is not a surprise, but the timing is, because the docket only indicated a hearing to determine whether or not Browning's taped confession could be used at his trial. 16-year-old Nick Browning Jr. wept as a prosecutor read chilling details of how he murdered his parents and his two younger brothers as they slept. It happened February 2nd inside the family home in Cockeysville. A sheriff's deputy brought him a box of tissues. The plea, hammered out in a jury room, came on the day defense attorneys were scheduled to argue against allowing prosecutors to use a recorded confession Browning made to police at trial. Browning pleaded guilty to four counts of murder in exchange for parole, following two consecutive life prison terms. Prosecutors had sought four life sentences without the possibility of parole. Browning was 15 when he shot his family, just 1 week shy of his 16th birthday. His parents dropped him off at a friend's house. Browning told his buddies he would go back to his house and take the family car so they could all drive around. He asked his brother Gregory to leave the basement door unlocked. Browning retrieved a 9mm pistol his father had been cleaning from a work area in the basement. During a hearing to transfer the case to juvenile court, a forensic psychiatrist testified Browning was in a trance-like state and doesn't remember pulling the trigger, but does recall hearing the shots. John Browning, a respected Towson attorney, was asleep on the sofa in the family room. Browning shot his father once in the head and remained next to him, waiting for other family members to come downstairs. He went upstairs and found his mother asleep in her bedroom, and he shot her twice. The forensic psychiatrist told the court during the transfer hearing that the killings followed an escalation in verbal and physical abuse by Browning's parents after he entered middle school. His two younger brothers were asleep down the hall. He shot 14-year-old Gregory once in the head. 11-year-old Benjamin began to stir. Browning shot him twice in the face. One of the bullets grazed Benjamin's left index finger as he put his hand over his face prior to being shot. Before leaving, he staged the scene to look like a burglary. He threw the gun and a spare magazine into some bushes at the end of his street, returned to his friend's house, played video games, and went shopping at the mall. As police interviewed Browning at his home after the bodies were discovered, various young people arrived, explaining that Browning invited them to come over that evening. Sentencing is scheduled for 9:30 a.m. December 2nd. The defense is asking that Browning be allowed to serve time at Patuxent Institution, which offers psychiatric treatment. Reporting live from Circuit Court in Towson, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.